Today, we're going to introduce Young Carers to Canadians. Alexandra is going to tell us a little bit about who Young Carers are. Matt and Ben will tell us why we should care and survey responses in other countries. Andrew will share our call to action: increased awareness, improved data collection and research, and a multi-sector approach.
Young carers may make dinner, go grocery shopping, take out the trash, or walk the dog. I know what you're thinking. All young people help around the house. But young carers do much more than that. Young carers may also provide ongoing emotional support, administer medication, pay bills, attend doctor's appointments, call 911, or lift and wash the person they're caring for. The degrees and types of care provided by young carers vary significantly, but there is a common denominator. They play substantial and significant roles. Also, while adult carers are primarily women, we know the gender balance between young carers is much more split. But being a young carer is not without its challenges. Young carers can suffer from increased levels of stress and anxiety. Sometimes young carers resent their role as a caregiver. Young caring can be physically demanding and cause fatigue. Finally, being a young carer can lead to a loss of childhood. The chance to connect with a relative in the final stages of their life or to help with the integrity of their family can be very positive for young carers. Being a young carer can lead to a greater personal resiliency in the face of other hard life situations. As we know, it is difficult to be different at school. Not being able to join in with extracurricular activities or hang out with friends can result in social exclusion and even lead to bullying. Young carers may also act out in class and exhibit other behavioral issues because they are dealing with the stress of their role. Being a young carer might result in needing to miss school in order to be there for a family member. Even if the young person does not miss school, young caring can result in chronic lateness. And also, young carers are often exhausted by their role. This can lead to a lack of concentration, difficulty completing homework, and ultimately make it hard to do well at school. All of this is to say that young carers sometimes face the choice between homework or home care. There is a lack of understanding of the role that young carers play. Sometimes young carers are seen as coming from broken families or simply as being different. The role can be stigmatized and prevent young carers from talking about what they do or asking for help for fear of something bad happening to their family. For all these reasons, young carers are an invisible population.
There are many reasons to care for young carers. Working as I do in an advocacy role for children and youth, I'm very aware of the discourse around children's rights that we must talk about when addressing an issue like young carers. In fact, Canada has committed to promote and protect the inherent rights of all children and youth through its very leadership in the signing of the UN Convention on the Rights of the Child in 1989. Children and youth have the right to protection from all forms of harm, abuse, neglect, and maltreatment. That means that in any intervention, we must ensure that young carers are not put at risk in their homes. All children and youth have the right to a high-quality education. That means young carers must be able to come to school in the morning free from the burden of having to worry for those at home or overtired and unable to focus in class or complete their assignments. All young people have the right to play and rest. Now play, my personal favorite, is that often forgotten right that must be guaranteed for all young carers. These are young people who are often stuck in the home and aren't able to reach out and have a full social life. And they must also be able to have plenty of rest and sleep to ensure that their cognitive development takes place as needed. One final point is that all young people have a right to be heard in matters that affect them, and this must be extended to young carers. On voit que dans Canada, il y a des jeunes aidants dans toutes nos classes. Dans une récente étude menée dans une école secondaire canadienne, on voit que 12% des jeunes de 12 à 17 ans s'identifient comme jeunes aidants. En plus que ça, on voit que dans les recherches menées dans les pays plus approfondis sur le sujet, qu'il y a une dizaine de milliers de jeunes aidants qui existent potentiellement ici au Canada. Bien que la quantité de recherche reste beaucoup à désirer, les premières indications nous suggèrent qu'on trouve des jeunes aidants à travers toutes les collectivités et à travers toutes les classes socio-économiques. Les garçons et les filles peuvent devenir jeunes aidants à des taux similaires, même que les jeunes de différentes origines ethniques, de situations familiales et eux qui habitent en milieu urbain, en milieu rural et dans les régions plus éloignées. So clearly there's a moral reason to support young carers in our communities. But the fact is that there's a very compelling economic case to be made as well. A 2009 study conducted in Australia demonstrated that the labor of young care saves that country's health care and social care systems approximately $18 billion per year. So providing support for young carers, we know, is less costly than not doing so, and the research in Australia and UK indicates that without support, young carers are less likely to go to school and less likely to be employed later on in life.
Several countries have taken significant steps to understand and respond to the reality of young carers. Most notably, Australia and the UK are leading the way when it comes to recognizing and supporting youth in need. Concrete measures in these countries include national data collection, legislation, national care strategies and action plans, respite options, and even a carer's allowance. There are only a handful of initiatives in Canada targeted at addressing the challenges and growing needs of young carers coast to coast. Research has just begun to unearth the issue of young caregiving in Canada. Just less than a year ago, the Vanier Institute of the Family published a report on young carers that laid out the issue of young caregiving for the first time in Canada. There are basically only three projects in Canada. The Young Care Initiative in the Niagara region set up the Powerhouse Project, which offers a variety of supports, including workshops, special events, a drop-in center, a resource library, and respite services. Hospice Toronto has recently developed a Young Carers program. This program operates within a large urban area and offers similar services to the Powerhouse Project. And they have also developed a toolkit resource that will help other organizations establish young care programs across Canada. The third initiative is the Cowichan Youth Caregivers Project, which is a three-year pilot situated on Vancouver Island within British Columbia. A resource support team was struck, comprised of young people and adults, and this team is responsible for the development of the documentary film Ending the Silence that you have all had a glimpse of today, and also for the development of a curriculum guide on young carers. While these projects are good examples, Canada is clearly behind countries like Australia and the UK.
We have three recommendations that are first steps to recognizing and supporting young carers. Our first recommendation is to raise awareness. Notre première recommandation est de sensibiliser la population. We must increase our knowledge of the term itself and the realities of young carers. This is particularly the case among those who work with youth. Increasing awareness will also help youth who are young carers to self-identify. Our second recommendation is to improve data collection and research. Notre deuxième recommandation est d'améliorer la collecte de données et la recherche. Understanding the scope and the dynamics of young caring in Canada is important to ensuring that young carers are properly supported. National, provincial, and territorial research bodies, such as Statistics Canada, must include questions about young carers to gather fundamental data to guide the policy development process. And Canada needs more academic research to explore all aspects of young caregiving in Canada. We call on researchers and on research funding bodies to add to our knowledge base. Our third recommendation is for a multi-sector approach. Notre troisième recommandation est d'adopter une approche multisectorielle. Young carers need support in many different areas of their lives. Educators, health professionals, and others whose work brings them into contact with young people must improve recognition of and support for young carers. Now, this should involve government, non-governmental organizations, the private sector, families, and young people themselves to leverage existing capacity to support young carers, but also to identify where existing resources are not sufficient. Here are some ideas, drawing on what we've seen elsewhere. A school response person to ensure that at least one adult in each school is aware of young caregiving is important. This allows that individual to help young carers, but also to teach other adults. Another idea is training, to include information about young carers among training programs for individuals who work with youth. A National Young Carer Day, a national day to raise awareness about young carers for all Canadians. Youth advisory councils, to ensure that as communities take steps to support young carers, those young carers and their peers have a voice in how that support is provided.
I'd like to invite the first of our three respondents to provide some of their insight to our report before we kick off our discussion. And that is Ms. Nora Springs, the CEO of the Vanier Institute, who helped get this issue on our radar.
Good afternoon. It's a pleasure to be here. For those of you that don't know the Vanier Institute, we were established 50 years ago by the then Governor General, Georges Vanier, to provide information, insights, and inspiration about and for Canadian families. I want to take this moment to congratulate the task force for A, having the courage to take on such a nebulous topic that is critically important, not only today, but for our future workforce, for our future families, and so congratulations to you all. In terms of your recommendations, the first one around raising awareness, you can have the Vanier Institute's full support on that, and I would invite you to submit an article for publication in our Transition magazine, and we'd be happy to start with that. In terms of your recommendation around research and data, the most recent is the 2007 Statistics Canada General Social Survey that looked at caregiving in Canada, and they started looking at caregivers 45 years of age and older. 45 years and older. And the only piece of information we have is one question that was asked: when did you start caregiving? And about 10% of the caregivers, women, said that they started when they were a teen or a young adult. And 7.5% of the men who were caregivers said they started as an adolescent or a young adult. And that number is almost 350,000. And that's those who've already reached the age of 45 or greater.
A significant component you also touched on was to ensure that we don't negatively stigmatize families with young carers. This is really about strengthening families so that young carers can thrive, and this is fundamental in all communications, whether it's one-on-one with families or speaking broadly to a larger community.
I see young carers at the hospital on a regular basis, and young carers for me, unfortunately, have both a personal and a medical story. I'm just thinking about this 15-year-old girl I saw very recently, who was caring for her mother with terminal cancer and who was presenting with depressive symptoms, or this 13-year-old boy who was caring for two brothers with cerebral palsy at home and who had serious drug and alcohol problems. I was never taught during my training to ask the key question, who is going to care for these children I see at the hospital when they go back home when healthcare professionals aren't caring for them anymore? We hope that today's presentation will be the very beginning of a Canadian conversation that is going to lead to concrete measures to support young carers across the country. On aimerait maintenant ouvrir la discussion, entendre vos impressions, vos commentaires, et espérons que ça va commencer à partir de maintenant.